Inspirational people, uplifting stories, Upbeat with Sandra Godley on BBC Coventry and Warwickshire.
Well, you know what? After battling breast cancer and beating it, my next guest thought her medical problems would be over. But due to the treatment she had, she ended up being left with a long-term condition, which is called lymphedema. And since her diagnosis, she's gone on to do something amazing for the community of people suffering with the same condition. The very, very wonderful, and I'm saying that big time, the very wonderful Gaynor Leach joins me in the studio now to tell me some more. Hello to you.
Hi, Sandra.
Hi, how are you feeling?
I'm fine.
Listen, producer Liz has been in and she set the scene, so it's all really nice and red and orangey in here. So there's a nice vibe in here.
Yes,
and it creates a lovely atmosphere just for us to hear your story. And I know it's going to impact a lot of people, so we're just going to relax together, yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah, we are. Okay, so what was it like then to be diagnosed with lymphedema?
Well, it was a bit of a shock because it's not something I knew about or expected. I was diagnosed with breast cancer in 2010, and we got it very early through a mammogram. Wouldn't have been found, wasn't a lump. It was like grains of sand in the tissue. So without the mammogram, it wouldn't have been found.
Wow.
So ladies, please go for your mammograms.
It's so important, isn't it? There's so much media attention on this at the moment, but good to hear you say that as well. Go for your mammograms. All right, carry on then, Mike.
And then I went through that. I had a small operation to remove the tissue. And on the 19th of December 2010, my breast consultant, I had an appointment with him, and he says, Gaynor, go home, enjoy Christmas and the next 20 Christmases.
Oh, okay.
So, wow. But we will do some radiotherapy. I'm pretty sure I've got it all, but if there's any cells remaining, the radiotherapy will mop it up.
Well, at that time, I mean, did you have a clear understanding what it even was at that time when you were diagnosed?
Absolutely not.
Not heard of it?
Not heard of it.
Nobody you knew?
No, nobody I knew. Nothing. Absolute shock when I got it.
Yeah.
And then, so I went through my radiotherapy. In my opinion, I sailed through my radiotherapy compared to some of my friends.
Mm-hmm.
But at the end of it, apart from being so tired, I didn't know what to do with myself. My boob was very hard, very red, beetroot red. And I went to see the oncologist for the normal follow-up. And she says, she had a look, asked me, I explained to her what was wrong. And she says, oh, my dear, I'm sorry, you have lymphedema.
Wow.
And my reaction was, lymph what?
Yes.
And kept repeating it.
Yes, I can imagine. What a shock.
It was. It was an absolute shock. And then when you go into it and then you find that it's, all you hear initially is that it's lifelong. And it's incurable.
They're the words, aren't they?
Yeah. And you don't hear it can be managed and treated.
Well, and that is so true. I mean, at that time, do you think people around you, maybe family and friends, do you think they understood what it was and the effects it would have on you?
At that time, no, absolutely not. And most people saying they've got it wrong. You know, this doesn't exist. Never heard of this. And of course, it was very, very real. And then you suddenly realise you've got a lot of lifestyle changes to make.
Yeah.
And you're giving a list of all the do's and don'ts. Half of the don'ts now we're discovering are myths.
That's interesting.
So we're moving on. But this is how we're moving on 5 years later.
Yeah, yeah.
Well, actually, it's nearly 9 years, isn't it, since the breast cancer. But
yeah,
because I didn't start the group until 2013.
And there's hope. And the great thing about your story is that you've been able to turn things around. I'm going to play a track and then we'll come back to how you have actually turned things around. And how are you helping other people as well? It's remarkable.
Thank you.
The place you live.
Found my home, you know, and everyone was so welcoming to me. I really felt like I belonged in this city, and that's why I've stayed ever since.
The stories you share.
There we were all sitting in this Rolls Royce. We got to Paris, slept on a bench in the park for a bit, and we went to the club we were playing, and the caretaker set his dog on us. It just gets worse and worse and worse. It'd make a great movie. People wouldn't believe it.
The music you love.
BBC Coventry and Warwickshire.
All the battles that I've won, they don't matter now, you're gone. Nothing matters now, you're gone.
I said I'm done with you, but I can't help it when I lay down, still think of you. Keeps me awake at night, and why do I let it get so far? How do we end with broken hearts? How do we end with broken hearts? Broken hearts.
So was it really worth it? Caught in the moment while we burn it down. No one's perfect. Try to connect, can we turn it round? Well, I'm over this game. No one's taking the blame. So was it really worth it? Was it really worth it?
Everything we've been criticizing.
Well, I don't wanna live like that.
Overthinking and analyzing.
You're never gonna take it back.
I thought I was winning, but I was dying.
Everything we never had.
Losing you is what I want fighting. Of all the battles that I've won, they don't matter now, you're gone. Nothing matters now, you're gone.
Well, you said you hated me. Tried to forget, but it stays with me. What scares me is when I'm locked up, got me feeling free. Does it come from the heart? Words cut deep, got deeper than scars. Thought that you were perfect. Was it really worth it?
Everything we've been criticizing.
Well, I don't wanna live like that.
Overthinking and analyzing.
You're never gonna take it back.
I thought I was winning, but I was dying.
Everything we never had.
Losing you is what I want fighting.
Of all the battles that I've won, they don't matter now, you're gone. Nothing matters now, you're gone.
All the battles that I've won, they don't matter now, you're gone. Nothing matters now, you're gone.
I'm too proud to call you, but I'm still thinking of you. Oh, I think I love you.
I'm too proud to call you, but I'm still thinking of you. Oh, I think I love you. I'm too proud to call you, but I'm still thinking of you. Oh, I think I love you.
All the battles that I've won, they don't matter now, you're gone. Nothing matters now, you're gone.
Sara Larson and Tom Walker here on BBC Coventry and Warwickshire with Now You're Gone.
Upbeat with Sandra Godley on BBC Coventry and Warwickshire.
Well, still with me in the studio tonight, I have Gain Leach, who, after being diagnosed with the long-term condition lymphedema, decided to set up a support group for others dealing with the condition. But before we go on, Gain, in layman's terms, what is lymphedema?
Lymphedema is the swelling which is part of the lymphatic system. And the lymphatic system is a network of channels and glands throughout the body that helps fight infection and removes the excess fluid.
I see. And the typical symptoms?
Heaviness, solid arm, leg, limb, in my case, boob.
Yeah.
And it's the swelling that gets it, extreme tiredness. So they used to say that there was no pain with lymphedema. Well, my members will tell you there's a lot of pain.
Looking back then, do you recognise any of those symptoms?
Yes.
Yeah, looking back.
Yes.
Yeah. Okay.
And the swelling, although I keep mine under control. Mm-hmm. The swelling from time to time, and especially with this heat coming.
Oh, wow. Yes. Yeah, huge heat wave coming. Mm. Okay, all right. Well, let's move forward then and start to talk about the support group that you've set up for dealing with the condition. How did that begin? How and why did you decide to do that?
Well, because I didn't understand the condition at all, I wrote research for a couple of years and then decided I'd got enough for a website, started a Facebook public page, and then people started joining that and putting their personal details on. And somebody says, Gaynor, this is not good enough. You need to start a closed support group. And I thought, support group online? But I did, and it took me nine months to work out how to set up a support group online.
Oh, my word.
But I did. And in our first month, we had 37 members. And now we have got over 1,100 members across the UK, and we've gone global.
You are amazing. That's incredible. Just from that initial thought, bit of nervousness, who am I? What can I do? Will anybody join? 37 in the first one. It's incredible.
Yeah.
Absolutely incredible. So looking back then, I mean, and also I guess looking forward a little bit, what have you been able to gain from creating this supportive community?
For me personally, I think it's given me a purpose in life. Instead of once I retired, I thought maybe I would be stuck in front of the telly or not doing anything. Or don't have time for that now. And it's up my computer skills. I had zilch when I started. And yeah, it's been absolutely, but it's good for me mentally and physically.
Sure. Yeah, to get out the house and be
yeah, and meeting
away.
People.
Yes.
And I meet the most incredible people.
Yeah, it must be quite humbling for
yes,
you.
Yes, it is.
Tell me about your work with Grapevine then.
Well, out of the blue, through Macmillan actually, because I have a really good relationship with the local Macmillan in Nuneaton. And I got to go on this course at Grapevine called the Innovation Factory. And the first one I went to was totally over my head. I was out
really?
Of my depth, like it was nobody's. I just couldn't. But they recognised it and they made life easier, got through the 2 days. Then the next year I went back and did another one just to make sure that I'd got it right. And then they've supported me all the way from there.
Yeah.
And they've paid for a lot of my training. I think on the voluntary sector, I was stuck in the 1970s.
Okay, but they
and
propelled
they dragged
you forward.
Me kicking and screaming into the day, and they've been so supportive.
Yeah,
cannot believe you and tell you how much they have supported me.
Well, I used the word propelled, but you said kicking and screaming. Fine, I'll go with your words. That sounds incredible. I want to read something that you've written here. The most important aspect of working with Grapevine is the people I meet. Each and every one of them either lives with a long-term condition or takes care of someone who has a challenged life, and yet they are passionate about helping others with daily challenges. So looking at that statement, which is incredibly powerful, what's your hope for the future? More education? Do you want to do more stuff on with that computer? It looks like you're a bit of a genius on it to expand your digital footprint.
I just want to make sure if I help one person who's got lymphedema, then I am more than happy. But at this moment in time, as I say, we've got 1,000 members. They're all very supportive of what we do.
Yeah.
And I'm absolutely thrilled that we are raising awareness of this condition that very few people know about.
Well, you off air, you did say to me there's an incredible statistic to support what you just said about the training for lymphedema. What was it that you said to me?
Doctors, GPs, consultants, whatever, when they're at medical school, they get 1 hour of training on the lymphatic system for 4 years. Therefore, if we go to our doctors and say we need antibiotics for an infection or we this or that or whatever's happening, they haven't got a clue.
Right.
So we have to train our own GPs.
Yes, that's incredible. And it's good to highlight that as well. I mean, of course, they're doing an awful lot of work, but it's good to highlight that. Let me give you a scenario then. So someone's had a recent diagnosis. What would you advise them to do?
I think, first of all, because it's such a shock and it seems to be such a big thing, is to make sure that they understand that they can help themselves. Self-care is the most important thing with lymphedema. So skincare every day, without fail, drinking lots of fluids like water, staying off the coffee, staying off the alcohol, and generally watching spicy foods, watch what you eat, try and control your weight, but skincare being the absolute most important. And then finally, I don't like the word exercise, my members don't like it, but keep moving.
That's a good one. I like that. Keep moving.
Whether it's clenching your fists if it's in your arms, or twiddling your toes if it's in your feet, or, you know, doing that with your feet, you know, doing a figure of eights. Anything that keeps you moving. And the most important thing, and you'll like this one,
okay,
Sandra.
Tell me.
Is singing. I can't sing.
I will teach you.
But when I go home, I can put the radio on, or I can put my favourite music on. Who cares?
Do you want to buy my CD, love? Me and you have got some in my handbag. Yeah. We'll sort that out.
And I can absolutely sing at the top of my voice. And that is good for me because it's been everything moving.
That is so good. Yes, I'm up for that one. And that's fabulous advice, because even if you think you can't sing, you can. You can make a noise. That's a brilliant top tip as well to leave with people. That's great, great. We'll have a chat about singing lessons afterwards. Gaynor, it's been a real pleasure to have you. You are one inspirational lady. And it's so good to hear your advice, and to have gone through all that you've gone through with a smile on your face, knowing that you're inspiring other people. It's really, really encouraging. Just before you go, how can people connect with you? What's your website? Now that you're a computer champion.
Oh, no. The website is www.lymph-what-edema.com.
I think you're going to say that again. Say it one more time, just so people can really, really get it.
lymph-what-edema.com.
That's all right. We've got it. Great way to connect with you as well. And well done for all that you're doing. And listen, I can't wait to hear so much more about the success stories. You're doing a great job.
Thank you, Sandra, and thank you for having me. It's been lovely to meet you.
Oh, it's been lovely to meet you too. Take care.